Hello, Ringgold High School, and thank you for watching Tiger Nation News. I'm Bryce Hart.
And I'm Sal Keith. Today is Friday, March 22nd. You know, we don't have long until spring break, about 4 days, and I'm pretty excited. How about you?
For sure. Me as well. I think it'll be good just to get a chance to catch our breaths and get a nice little break.
Well, let's start with a look at the lunch forecast for next week, Dawson.
Monday, we got chips and queso, or barbecue quesadillas, with sides of glazed carrots and fruit. Tuesday, chicken sandwiches, or ham sandwich and Doritos, with sides of broccoli dippers, baked beans, and fruit. Wednesday, watch out, we got corn dogs and Philly cheesesteaks rolling out with sides of carrot dippers, fries, and fruit. Thursday, you might want to take shelter because we got chicken tenders or chicken Alfredo on the menu, with sides of green beans, mashed potatoes, and fruit. Thursday, there's no school for Good Friday, so bake a ham for the family. As always, chef salad and pepperoni or cheese pizza with milk to drink will be options every day. Well, that's it for next week's lunch forecast. Bryce and Sal, back to you.
Speaking of delicious treats, Kahona Ice was here yesterday. It's always a popular day on campus when the Kahona Ice truck comes in. Here's some video of a visit from last semester. The flavor choices are endless. Prices range from $3 to $7. We hope to see more of Kahona Ice truck in the future.
It's almost time for the spring plant sale. Agriculture classes have been working on growing plants to sell as a fundraiser. It will be held on April 12th and 13th. They have everything from flowers to houseplants to vegetable plants.
1 week left to vote on PBIS Kiss a Critter contest. Students are collecting dollars and change in jars in the cafeteria. The teacher jar that raises the most money has to kiss one of the animals in the agriculture. The voting has been going on for weeks. Here are your candidates: Mr. Ogle, Mr. Bratton, Ms. Dindy, Mr. Wright, and Mr. Bryce.
Here are the stats so far. Last week, Mr. Wright had quite a lead, but Ms. Dindy has recently taken off in the votes. Keep voting by putting money in the jars. You will have to tune in next week on TNN to find out who the winner is. Watch live as the winner kisses the critter. RHS had a great day at State Literary Competition. Ellie Talley is your new 3A state champion for dramatic monologue. And Braden Roach is the second best in the entire state for boys vocal solo. And by the way, yesterday, RHSBA earned 10 nominations for the musical Peter Pan and one honorable mention. TNN was there with RHSBA students when they learned of the nominations.
Our first category is Best Direction of a Musical. And the nominees are Brandy Carter.
The nominations included Best Direction, Music Direction, Choreography, Ensemble, Technical Execution, Lighting, Scenic Design, Costume, Best Performance Leading Actress, Standing Ovation, and Overall Production. The honorable mention was in Best Sound, and we have an exciting new detail just in today.
That's right, students will get to perform live on GPB for the Schuler Awards on April 18th at 8 p.m. They will get to perform a piece from Peter Pan, and junior Ivy O'Neill will get to sing in the medley with the other five best actresses in the whole entire state. Honestly, it was just a crazy moment getting those 10 nominations. We've worked very diligently and very hard. A lot of us being at the school for the past 3 weeks from 3:30 to 9 p.m. So to get those 10 nominations was, we don't need nominations to tell us that we did our job as performers, but it's always nice to get that recognition. Really, really special moment, seeing our directors be successful, and addition to Ivy O'Neill. She's absolutely amazing, getting selected as one of the top five best in the whole entire state. She worked extremely hard, so we're definitely proud of her.
Wow. I just want to say, you guys are awesome.
Thank you.
And you keep doing what you do. Peter Pan performances for the public might be over, but there's good news. All the proceeds from one of the matinee ticket sales on March 9th were collected. RHSPA was able to donate over $4,200 to communities and schools. That's service in action, one of our Tiger expectations.
Reality U is coming to RHS next week. We caught up with the RHS site coordinator, Melanie Smith, to ask her some questions about the event.
Reality U is an opportunity for freshmen to step in and be an adult for a day. So what they're going to do is they will get their passport, and this is going to be based on their GPA. It's based on the survey that they filled out before the day of Reality U, and they are given a job. They are given amount of money that they make. Some of them will be married. Some of them will have children. And all of that's based on the survey that they did. And after they get the job that they have, the amount of money they have, they're going to have to go around and live life as an adult. You're going to have to get a house. You're going to have to get a car. You're going to have to get insurance. Do you need daycare because you have a child? So all of this is pretending to be an adult for a day and seeing here's what all we need to do to make life work as an adult. This is important because it's giving the freshman the opportunity to see, here's how your grades affect your future. Here's how what you want for your life, how it starts out your freshman year, how you can work towards your goals later on in life by doing what you need to do today. We do Reality U so that freshmen can see my GPA really does matter. If my goal is to be a doctor, then I need to have a high GPA so I can get into the medical schools that I want to get into. What are your goals post high school? We want to help you see that as a freshman, how that plays out in your life and how that's going to help you right now to get you where you want to be in the future. It's just one day. We're just going to do this for one day. It's going to be a lot of fun. Jump in and have fun with it. And you might be given a career and might think, I don't know that I ever am going to do this in real life, but today we're going to have fun with it. You get to, for instance, you get to pick the kind of car you want. Some people will come in and pick a very expensive car and then realize, you know what? If I have that car, I don't have money for groceries. So they have to go back and reevaluate and pick maybe a cheaper car so that they can also have groceries. So it's a lot of fun, and it's just being an adult for a day.
By the way, we still need volunteers for this. It can be anyone in our community. They will man the booths and provide students information about available products or services that they will purchase. Booth examples include utilities, insurance, housing, transportation, supermarket, basically all the necessities that you need.
Spread the word to your friends and family. You do not have to be an expert. All information for your booth will be provided. It's an incredible opportunity for our community to engage with local students and learn more about their individual impact on the future.
TNN continues our segment called Teacher Talks with a different teacher this week. TNN reporter Dominic Cawthorn is in the studio to tell us who he interviewed this week. Dominic?
My name is Coach Gray. I've been teaching for, 17 years. I started in 2006, so it's been a while.
What made you?
I started teaching on a snap decision because I was in college and I was pre-dentistry, and I decided there was no way I was going to school that much longer. And people have really gross teeth, and I didn't want to look at it all day. So, teaching fit.
Prom tickets are officially on sale. Here are some things to remember. It will be held at the Chattanoogan Hotel in downtown Chattanooga on Saturday, May 4th from 7 to 10 p.m. Tickets will be $50 per person. All students must get a permission form signed and returned before purchasing tickets. You can get these forms in the office.
All guests must be at least in 9th grade, in good standing with their school, and no more than 20 years old. All fees have to be paid before tickets are bought. The formal dress code must be followed, which is described on the RHS prom website. There will be a senior walk at Wood Station Elementary Thursday, March 28th. That's next week. It starts at 8:15 a.m. Make sure to bring your cap and gown.
There will be a Kennesaw State University campus tour on April 19th, but the permission form and payment is due on April 12th. Your baby pictures for the senior slideshow are also due on that day. There will be a senior walk at Ringgold Elementary on April 25th.
On April 29th, seniors have the opportunity to go to Topgolf. Permission forms and $15 payment is due by next week on March 28th. No extra tickets will be ordered after this date, and the money is not refundable.
Seniors also have a trip planned to Dollywood on May 22nd. Payment of $100 is due by April 10th. We have to pay for all tickets and charter buses up front and cannot get a refund on these for these companies. Therefore, there will not be any refund of any money if you decide not to go. See Ms. Holcomb for more information.
We're going to take a break and show you some upcoming events when we come back. We will talk to the RHS Staff Member of the Month, Connie Coker.
Thank you.
congratulations to Ms. Coker for Administrative Secretary for being voted to RHS Staff Member of the Month for February.
TNN reporter Joseph Brumfield sat down with her to ask some questions about working here. Check it out.
I'm Joseph Brumfield.
And I'm Connie Coker.
Congratulations on being voted Staff Member of the Month. What is your passion at Winkle High School?
Thank you very much. I feel very honored. I love our teachers and our students, and I've been here a very long time. Do I have to tell?
You don't have to, or?
I'm beginning my 48th year.
Okay. How long have you worked at OTS?
I'm starting 48.
What is your favorite thing about Winkle High School?
Getting to do what I like to do. I started out being a bookkeeper years ago. I'm the administrative assistant. And now I get to do all of those things and then go to all the fun stuff like football and basketball and baseball and soccer and all those good fun things.
What about track?
Well, I've not been to a track meet. So sorry.
It's
but
okay.
I did buy donuts from you.
Yeah, I know. What do you like to do for fun?
Well, even though I don't go to the track meets, I do like to walk. So I like to walk. I do about 2 miles a day. And I like to read and relax and be outside after being inside all day long.
Wow. What is your favorite food?
Hard to pick just one, because you can tell by looking at me, I do love to eat. Probably I like fish and fresh vegetables and salads.
Where is your favorite place to go on vacation?
Anywhere outside. I like the beach, but I don't go much anymore because I have a pool at home. So just being outside. The southeast is my favorite though.
Hi, I'm Bryce Hart. I'm 17 years of age. I'm a junior here at Ringgold High School. Some things I like to do. I play football here at Ringgold High School. I'm an inside linebacker. I'm in the theater program here, RHS Performing Arts. I like to write poetry. I actually want to publish a book before I turn 18. I've written about 50 plus poems. I also like to study apologetics in my free time, which is the art of defending your faith and enhancing the faith of others, biblically and historically. I also enjoy the exercise palace, or in other words, the gym. I'm not just a meat-headed jock. Like, it's not just for my body. Also mentally, it just kind of helps me sift through my thoughts and work through everything I maybe, you know, got going on upstairs. So, yeah. This is the next segment, Miles. And now music. I love music that has a message and that gets deeper than the surface, because it like provokes my brain to think and I can connect to it. It's like artists like NF that have like a deeper meaning, other artists as well. Also things that I can sing. John Legend, love singing John Legend. Things of that nature. In addition to like sometimes when I'm studying, I'll listen to classical music. There's not much to think about when you listen to classical music, no lyrics to digest. So it's kind of just easier to listen to when I'm studying. And now finally, quotes. This quote originally from the world's 5-time fittest man, Matt Frazier. I will do today what others won't, so tomorrow I may do what others cannot. And to me, that means like sacrificing now and doing the little things right, doing the little things nobody else is willing to do, because a lot of people want to be successful. So doing the little things in your field or your craft or what you like to do, that is going to set you apart in the future. And then second, I would like to say that pride is a big issue for a lot of people, and sometimes when you haven't humbled yourself, it prevents you from connecting with people because you constantly put yourself above everybody else. So a scripture I like to keep in mind is Proverbs 16:18. Pride comes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall. Haughty meaning arrogance. So that just kind of keeps rushing my mind that it's important to keep myself humble so I can continue to connect with people and have those genuine relationships and not just like put myself on this pedestal. Because at the end of the day, we all bleed red and no one person is above the other.
Hey guys, Higgy Spencer here, and guess where we're going? Comic-Con. It is 11 a.m. It's not going to be at its biggest on a Sunday, but it'll be pretty fun, and I can't wait to show you guys. Hey guys, we're on our way to Comic-Con right now. You can probably tell who I'm going to be. I'm obviously Wolverine, and yeah, we're on our way, so I can't wait to get there.
Is this your first Comic Con?
No. This is like my seventh year, I think, in this show.
Wow. Yeah. This is my first one. Is it fun to do?
Yeah, they're always a good time.
Yeah. Do you get a lot of like autographs to sign?
Oh, yeah, I do that a lot. In books, it's really nice when someone brings up a book that I've worked on and that I didn't sell to them here. So it's kind of neat to see those reader copies come back.
So you've worked with Marvel and DC?
Yeah.
What was that like?
That's always interesting, because it's fun to see your stuff in stores and out in the real world, and not just on your computer or on your drawing desk at home.
So you would describe your style as bold?
Yeah, I think so, because it's got deep black. A lot of times I go for high contrast, so that's why I like the label.
What's your favorite part of drawing?
Probably trying to customize it to be my own thing versus what I've seen before. Like taking a character that doesn't like necessarily look like that style. So I like to apply my look to something that's unusual, like an animation character, like a princess, or something like that, do a shadowy kind of look.
Character most proud?
Well, probably my Spider-Man cover that I did for Marvel Comics. That's one of my most proud things. It's just neat to think that I got to contribute to that. You can see that lineage back all the way to Stan Lee, Steve Ditko, and they created that book. It's just neat to be in that timeline.
Do you watch the Marvel movies?
I do, and I've done stuff with promotional art for those as well, like posters and t-shirts and stuff.
What would you say is the most, what's the funniest thing about this job?
Probably getting to see, I get pictures from Marvel sometimes, like on-set photography, so I know what costume looks like and stuff, and that's really neat to think that I'm seeing something before the movie's released.
That's awesome. Yeah, great work, man.
Great.
Yeah, thanks for agreeing.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to shake the
Comic-Con. It was really fun. This is my first one ever, so definitely a new experience to cross off the bucket list. It was a really fun time, seeing a bunch of passionate people in costumes and, just walking around and seeing all the cool stuff. It's fun, just seeing people talking about and like making stuff they're passionate about. Pretty fun, and I think I'm gonna come here next year.
Idea for TNN? Maybe there's a story you want us to cover. Maybe you have a segment idea. Let us know.
At Tiger Nation News, we're always hunting for content to bring to you. That's it for this week's Tiger Nation News. Remember our Tiger expectations: respect, honesty, and service.
Thank you for watching, and go Tigers!